Welcome back. In this video, you're going to learn how to edit your own video in a program called Screenflow in a way that's simple, effective, and fun.
I love that. We're going with that. That is staying in.
And here we are on my desktop, ready to start editing in Screenflow. As you can see right here, this is the single film clip that we're going to be using today. And to get into Screenflow, I'm just going to go down to my dock and find the film camera with two reels. That is Screenflow. So now, in terms of all of these menus, the only one we're going to be working with today is the only one that really matters, and that's going to be in the File menu. So I'm going to have you guys click on the File menu, come down here to New Empty Document, and what that's going to do is it's going to create for us the new timeline that we're going to use. So click on that. Then you guys have this new dialog box pop up. And if this is the first time you're using Screenflow, it's probably set itself by default to screen dimensions. What that means is Screenflow is actually a very smart program, and it calculates the size of the screen that you have. You see the numbers for mine. Yours are going to be different. Yours are probably more high def. I have a really, really good screen that can produce some really big pictures. So that's why my numbers are probably a lot bigger than what you guys are going to see. But it doesn't matter, because what we all want is to come down here, click on that box, get the drop-down menu, and we want the 1080p HD, because this is going to YouTube, and your video was probably shot in HD anyway, on your cell phone or a camera that can do it. All cameras can do it nowadays. And see how Screenflow automatically corrected all of those numbers for us, so you guys don't have to worry about them. Click the Create button, and boom, here is our new timeline. Lots of stuff going on here, and most of it we can ignore. All of this video stuff on the side here, we are going to ignore. So what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna skip over all of these icons and come here to this music note with this rectangle. What this is going to allow us to do is bring in that video that you saw of me on my desktop. And to get to that, we're going to come down here to the Add Media button, click, and then we get this new window that says, okay, you've asked me to add the media. Where is it? Well, it's automatically thrown me to my desktop, which is fantastic. We know that because it says desktop here, and also too, over here in my file tree, it says desktop here. But in case, let's say, I was somehow in the users folder, or I was lost somewhere. It didn't pop up like that. I'll click on desktop, boom, we're back on the desktop, and here I am. There's my clip. I come down here to the flashing blue button, hit open, and boom, I pop up right here. So, a couple different ways that I can drag myself in here. I can go ahead, click on this clip, and bring myself right here and match me into that black box. And it should snap for you, and you should sort of be seeing it jerk itself in there. That's one way to do it. Second way to do it, come back here to this icon, click on it once, then click, and if you drag it straight to the timeline, you can do that. And obviously you have now learned you can do that as many times as you want. Now, we only want one of me, so boom, we've deleted those two. So now we want to edit, but it's sort of a small icon, right? Because our timeline is registered to do 5 minutes and 30 seconds. That's how zoomed out we are. Well, that's not gonna work for us because, well, that's teeny tiny. So what you wanna do is come down to the zoom actuator right here. There's the small magnifying glass and there's the large one. And all you gotta do is find the ball, click and drag, and there you go. Lots of programs have this feature, so I'm sure that you all are very, very much used to it. I like, when I zoom in, I like seeing the length of the clip be the length of the screen. I like things to be as big as possible so I can see them. So that's why mine is the length of the screen. The other cool thing too that you've probably already recognized as well in Screenflow is that when it comes to your audio, it gives you this waveform, and this is invaluable because you can visually see where you want to make your edits, because you can tell when you're talking and when you're not talking. Like here at the beginning, for example, it's this flat green line, then if we were to imagine the line over my thumbnail here, I'm not saying anything, I'm still not saying anything. I don't say anything till right here. So we know that's where our first edit's gonna be. We're gonna trim off all of this fat. And the way that we're gonna do that So I'm going to have you click on your icon right here so you get that yellow border. Hover over the beginning here until your cursor goes from an arrow to this double arrow looking thing. And once you have that, click, keep holding down, and then drag. And there you go. You can see there is our first edit. Once you do that, the thumbnail pops back up. And again, that's our first edit. To edit the end here, do the same thing. Come back, hover around that white border, wait for the double arrow, which I had. There we go, boom. Click and drag. And also to that little duration panel there is being so kind in telling us not only the white number is how long our clip is, the red number is actually the length that we have cut away. So the duration of the clip right now is 8.9 seconds, and we have deleted 5.4. If I go forward, those numbers change and go the other way. If I come back, they change to what they originally were. Cool. So once you have that done, just click to release, and now we have our single clip. Now, one last thing we want to do before we're finished is we want to take this clip and butt it up against the beginning here. If we don't do that, if we forget to do that, and we jump to exporting, you are going to have this huge gap of black before you see yourself. Click on your video, and then click and drag it all the way to the front. So the beginning is actually at the beginning, and you guys know what the playhead here is, the playhead with the vertical red line. If I hit the space bar, it begins to play it.
You're gonna learn how to edit your own video in a program called Screenflow in a way that's simple, effective, and fun.
And that's it. That is how to edit a single clip video in Screenflow. And in the next video, what I'm gonna do is show you how to upload that to YouTube or the website of your choice. So we'll see you then.
To get your own copy of Screenflow, click the link in the description box below. And while you're there, click the thumbs up icon to like this video and leave me a comment below telling me what other videos you want to see. To subscribe, click the top video. To learn more cool stuff, click the bottom one.